Service is underway in Daytona Beach right now for the mother and two children killed in an accident on I-95. They died when the car slammed into the overpass on the southbound exit ramp at LPGA Boulevard. WESH 2's Talitha Vickers is live outside the mosque in Daytona Beach where that service is being held. Talitha.
Amanda, prayer services just wrapping up here, and I tell you, I had an opportunity to go on the women's side of this Islamic center, and there was a tremendous amount of overwhelming group grief. Our photographer James went on the men's side, same deal over there as well. Many just devastated by yesterday's tragic accident. Take a look at some of the video from inside the Islamic center at Daytona Beach, where a prayer service for loved ones killed in a tragic accident happened. Men and women gathered to pray for healing during this time of grief. This video from Chopper 2 shows the accident that claimed the life of Michelle Zulfikar and her 10-year-old son who died on scene. Zulfikar's 3-year-old daughter, also a passenger, was rushed to the hospital and later died. Her 4-year-old brother was the only survivor. Investigators say the mother was behind the wheel of this Mercedes van when it left the roadway for an unknown reason. Witnesses say they never saw the vehicle slow down or brake lights come on as the van approached and eventually hit the wall to the overpass at the I-95 southbound exit ramp at LPGA Boulevard. The impact so intense, the van flipped. Investigators say none of the 4 passengers had seat belts or child safety seats. Family friends are still in shock.
Michelle Zulfikar was very religious. She was an outstanding mother. She was a good wife. She was very kind. She was devoted to her family. She loved her children. She loved all children, but she loved her children.
This same family continuing to deal with loss. They actually lost their 2-year-old son back in 2006 in a boating accident on Father's Day. Their toddler fell off of a boat, hitting a propeller as the boat was docking along the Halifax River. Now, folks, the child that did survive was taken to Halifax Medical Center, listed in critical condition. We have no further updates on the condition of that child. Reporting live from Daytona Beach, Talitha Vickers, WESH 2 News.